Well, once again, the United States government has proven that why do a little of a good thing when it can do far too much of a good thing? What I'm talking about is the new TSA guidelines of having that little probe that checks underneath your clothes to make sure that you aren't a terrorist and that you aren't going to blow up an airplane. Which is really odd because, well, speaking of odd, we're about to talk about odds. Yes, the odds are pretty fucking low you're going to die on an airplane in a terrorist attack. In fact, and the link is, guess where? Right on my lap. But the odds of you dying in a terrorist attack in an airplane are approximately, and mind you, this is a success to failure ratio, unlike the Las Vegas failure to success ratio. I just want to make that clear right here. Now, the odds are 1 in 10,400,000. Or, to put it another way, you have a 2,000% greater chance of being struck by lightning. But some of you are going to go ahead and say, well, what about the 9/11 attacks that occurred? Now, first, the statistic did not include the victims in the Twin Towers. Now, we approximately lost 4,000 people. If you factor that in, well, the odds are quite a bit significantly lower for living, as the odds of success for the terrorist go up to an amazing 1 for every 1,501,000 passengers, or 300% the rate of success for lightning strikes. Oh dear, how am I ever going to get to sleep at night knowing that the odds are stacked against the terrorists? Now, if you're like me, you're probably wondering, how the hell is it that the TSA can continue to use more invasive programs to check out passengers that are flying if the airlines are so safe as of now? Quite frankly, I have an idea, and you're responsible. Yes, you chicken-hearted motherfucker, you know who you are. You're the one who's saying, I don't want to be killed by the terrorists. Oh my God, it's a horrible death. Never mind the horrible deaths that happened by drunk driving on the road. Never mind the horrible deaths that are caused by lightning. Actually, four of them. Then, of course, terrorist attacks, mind you. Never mind all that. You're just afraid of brown people, aren't you? Come on, admit it. You know it's true. So, the United States of America has turned from the land of the free and the home of the brave to the land of the bigots and the home of the chicken-hearted. Great job. So, did the TSA regulations do anything at all to help us be safer in the airlines? Certainly, they did some, and although I would argue we certainly don't need any more invasive searches like they're going to do, why, I can just imagine the first time that a terrorist goes ahead and sticks a bomb either up the poop chute or into the vag. Now, if you don't think that a bomb that's about this size can go ahead and fit up either the poop chute or the cooch, you've been watching the wrong porn, son. Seriously. Yes, folks, it's going to be speculum time for everyone. Isn't that great? Oh, yeah. Quite frankly, what is the greatest defense against terrorism on the airlines? Simple. It is called the vigilance of the citizenry. Something that used to be depended on, but now has been flushed down the toilet of fear. Thanks, United States Congress, and thank you, American people, for making this shit happen. Fuck you!